The Miracle of Mind Dynamics, A New Way to Triumphant Living. Written by Joseph Murphy, D.D., D.R.S., Ph.D., LLD. Narrated by Chas Mandala. Preface. This book is the result of more than 40 years of pioneering in the field of mental and spiritual laws. To make these laws and the understanding of them available to the masses, I have written this book. To make it as easy as possible for you to start deriving results from the application of these mental and spiritual principles, I have included specific details and illustrations on methods and techniques. I have taught the contents of this book to people in nearly every country of the world, in radio programs and on television appearances, in public talks and class lectures in America, Europe, South Africa, India, Australia, Israel, etc. Thousands of people have told me in social conversations, personal counseling, and by mail and telephone about the miraculous results made manifest in their lives by the application of these age-old truths which are clearly set forth in each chapter of this book. These people have found healing of so-called incurable diseases, complete freedom from guilt, prosperity and success in business where before they felt stymied and blocked, how to be well and stay well all the time where before they had relapses, how to tap the source of good fortune where before they could not make ends meet, peace of mind where there had been discord and confusion, fulfillment of desires where there has been frustration, marital happiness where before there had been hatred and resentment and divorce was threatened, harmony in homes and offices where there had been discord and quarreling. The people who have used and benefited from the mental and spiritual laws outlined in this book, to my personal knowledge, belong to all religious denominations. Some were self-styled agnostics, and others were so-called atheists. Moreover, they came from every area of society and every income bracket. They are motion picture stars, writers, doctors, dentists, pharmacists, heads of corporations, university professors, missile scientists, engineers, taxi drivers, housewives, stenographers, gardeners, housemaids, and chauffeurs. These people discovered that their destiny is in their own hands because, as you will learn in this book, it is impossible to think one thing and produce another, and that by correct thinking, from the standpoint of the universal law of harmony, a happy, productive life results. Here you will learn that your thought is the key to life, for as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. These people have found how to apply the laws of life, which has taken all guesswork out of their prayer life. They have learned, in a scientific way, how to bring health, wealth, love, and beauty into their lives by learning how to synchronize their conscious and subconscious minds. You can have power to make your life healthy, joyous, useful, and outstandingly successful if you will read and apply the laws of life set forth in this book. This book is written with simplicity and dramatic clarity. It shows you how you may achieve the personal power which overcomes fear and banishes worry and anxiety, opening up the way to a grander, finer, happier, and richer living. From this page onward, we shall venture together toward the greatest of all prizes, triumphant living. Chapter 1. How to Be Well and Stay Well All the Time. I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. Triumphant Living. You can be well and stay well, and so conduct and control your life that you can live with a marvelous and victorious sense of health and vitality. Men and women are gradually awakening to the fact that their physical condition is determined largely by their emotions. Your emotional life is regulated by the way you think all day long. Last year, during a visit to Bermuda, I met a man in the hotel lobby who told me he was over 90 years of age. I found him indomitable, full of vital energy, zest, and enthusiasm. His face glowed with joy and laughter. I asked him how, at over 90, he could feel so vital, alert, and energetic. He replied, "It is very simple. I just refuse to worry or get over tense. I am full of goodwill to all men, I hold no grudges, I have forgiven myself and others, and I live in God, and God lives in me. For 15 minutes every morning on arising, I claim that God pours out His energy, power, strength, joy, love, and beauty into every cell of my body, rejuvenating and restoring my whole being. I yield myself to Him, and the almighty power courses through my veins and through my soul." This man had never been sick in his life. He had no special diet and ate everything that was served to him at the hotel. He said that when a man eats his food with joy and thanksgiving, the creative intelligence within man transmutes the food to vital energy and beauty of skin. This man's discussion reminded me of a passage of the Scripture. "They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint." The word "wait" means to quiet the wheels of your mind, to relax, to let go, and to tune in on God. Get your mind synchronized with God's river of peace, life, and love, and move with the rhythm of the divine. In tune with the infinite. A simple way to tune in with God is to meditate slowly, quietly, and lovingly on the 23rd, 27th, or 91st Psalm, absorbing the truths therein. Then you will get into harmony with the creative force of the universe. If you want to be well and stay well, I suggest that you get overwhelmingly interested in the great eternal truths of God, which have come down to us from time immemorial. Get a consuming interest in life, God, nature. Devote yourself to some worthwhile project which will benefit and bless humanity. Throw yourself mentally and emotionally into the project, work for it, know it is good, and you will be filled with vital energy and enthusiasm. How She Triumphed Over Boredom. I knew a woman about 50 years of age, chronologically speaking. She was bored, jaded, tired, and cynical. She had no consuming interest but herself. She was constantly talking about her aches, pains, and conflicts. I told her to take a vacation from herself. She was wearing herself out and had jangled nerves and insomnia as a result. Moreover, she was rapidly disintegrating, deteriorating mentally, actually dying on the vine. At my suggestion, she took up a study of flowers. Also, her latent talent for music was explored. She took lessons on the piano from a wonderful instructor who encouraged her. She became completely absorbed with the beauty of flowers and rearranged her garden. As a result of her new interests, she has been invited to speak on flower arrangements and give musical entertainment for her husband's guests. She gets a great joy and thrill in releasing her imprisoned splendor. She learned that when the mind is disturbed, a wonderful technique of healing is to become absorbed, engrossed, and interested in nature, where beauty, order, symmetry, rhythm, and proportion prevail. When the mind is projected on the order and beauty of nature, the mind is thereby transformed and renewed, which results in a healing. In many hospitals in England and elsewhere, for instance, it is customary to have mentally disturbed patients engage in making toys, purses, chairs, attend to the gardens, and plant flowers. By this manual engagement in various handicrafts, the minds of these patients become transformed into a healthy, normal condition once more. The Secret of Getting Well. During a visit to San Francisco some months ago, I visited a friend.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.